Hi everyone, today I will review the Suzuki Swift from the first generation that was built between 2004 and 2010. I will examine this car for you. This is in my opinion a good car for the city. It's powerful and economical at the same time. The car I review today is the 2008 model, so this is kind of a run-out model for this generation. From the start, I would recommend to buy a car with the antenna at the back of the roof. This Shogun model has been made in Japan. I like watches and I like electronics. Nothing beats the Japanese in these fields. The same applies to cars. This Shogun model was built in Japan. All stereotypes aside, this car is better than the ones that were built in Eastern Europe. Cars that were built in Europe had the antenna in the front of the roof. Cars from Japan had the antenna at the back of the roof. Engine-wise, this car has the 1.3 four-cylinder engine that produces a healthy 92 horsepower. Compared with my old Volkswagen Polo, this car is a blast to drive. The engine will rev with much enthusiasm. The 5-speed manual feels a little bit cheap, but very effective when it's warm. It's pretty smooth. Let's inspect this car a little bit more. Suzuki tried to go into the marketplace of the Mini. The Mini is more premium, but the Swift satisfies in driving ability and will offer quite some value for money. I will compare it to the Volkswagen Polo from 2004. This Swift is definitely more fun to drive. Yes, you got some cheap plastics here and there, but what do you expect? You can drive this car in the city. That's what this car is built for, in my opinion. It will feel at home on almost every road. From a standstill, it will perform really well. Drive it for long distances and you will notice that the fuel economy is great. For about 40 euros, you will fill up the tank and can drive 600 kilometers with ease. I really come to respect this engine. I love German cars, but in this segment, the Swift beats the Polo in my opinion. Basically, if you search a car that's reliable, quite fun to drive, and does not cost too much, look no further than this car. I know that the exterior design is not very good, but the more you drive the car, the more you come to respect it. There's not much to find about issues with this engine. And if there are some issues with this engine, it's quite cheap to fix. These cars are not very refined, but a second car for the groceries and some small trips with this car performs very well indeed. Japanese engineering might not be very refined, but this is quite reliable. With that being said, this is the perfect car for small trips around the city. Do not drive long trips with this car. It will become tiring over time. The sound insulation is not very sufficient, and you will get tired after a few hours. This car is built for the city and not for long motorway stretches. I do not have issues to report since this car is quite reliable. The tech under the hood is very simple. Only thing to report is that corrosion from cars fabricated in Eastern Europe are more prone to rust. Thanks for watching. We hope to see you guys in the next video.